is what has happened after the 2012 elections, part due to redistricting.
And yes, I rent my own home. My daughter-in-law is in the audience, and I have to be very careful how I say this because I was addressing a group one time when I was mentioning I rent my own home, and she said, "You can stay there as long as you behave." And it is true, we have registered Angus cattle and enjoy it very much. However, when my son got married, I went out and found a Hereford heifer calf to show that we really welcomed my daughter-in-law to the family. And since then, the red and whites are taking over more and more space. I don't know if we'll get to black baldies, but we're working on it. Well, you heard Secretary Hipsch cover the big picture issues that the governor faced when he arrived. Some of the focuses that he has moving forward in that agenda. But I'll give you a little glimpse from my own personal point of view. I'm very, very lucky that I've had the opportunity to serve in this capacity twice. That's a real rarity. And what I will tell you, the first time round, I had a great deal of friendship with the other cabinet members, but there were times when we did not agree. And we had some very strong arguments about our opinions on issues. And then the spears came out and went in the ground, and then you'd have to go find a mediator out of the governor's office to step in and resolve the issue and give direction to the agencies. What I really appreciate about this cabinet is not only are they good friends, but we are all cooperators. This governor does not expect to have to step in and mediate on issues. He expects that the cabinet members will sit down and resolve issues that will be for the betterment of Wisconsin and not for agency preservation. And I'm very happy to say to you today, after 2 years of experiencing this, it works. The Department of Natural Resources and the Department of Agriculture, as you're well aware, work together on many environmental type issues, whether it's water or land or pesticides or invasive species or on and on. We generally come together with a common agreement on how we are going to approach it. And I will give you an example. NRCS, which is a federal agency, creates the baseline for environmental program activities with its Rule 590. Now, this is going to get boring with all these numbers. But that's how it's created, 590. And then along comes Natural Resources. And they take that rule as a basis for developing the rules of the state of Wisconsin for standards for environmental, meeting environmental challenges. And the reason they do that is so if you are participating in a federal program following one set of rules, and you also are required by the state of Wisconsin to follow a set of rules, it's necessary to have the same rules on both sides of the ledger, so that you don't get confusion on whether you're meeting it right or wrong. Well, then along comes the Department of Ag, Trade, Consumer Protection, and we give you the guidance, the farming community, the guidance on how to meet those standards that the DNR has created. So that's how we work together and how we coordinate and how we interact. That's no less true in ag tourism. It's no less true with the Department of Revenue. It's no less true with the Department of Financial Institutions.